Yeah, you know, you did you a little stretch, true. But you're still a soldier, right?
The top five soldiers from HBO's The Wire.
You're a soldier, Bodie.
Now, hearing that word soldier, it's impossible not to associate it with war. I mean, I guess if the shoe fits, right? Constant battles with the police and other crews.
Do what you feel, but be ready to finish what you start.
Definitely turned those Baltimore streets into a war zone. Now, The Wire had a variety of great soldiers to choose from. From the tactical.
Why this boy gotta get dead just for talking shit?
To the brutal.
Look, hold on, girl, we wanna slap!
To the stupidest of stupids.
Like a 40 degree day.
The Wire is goated for having the best soldiers in the game. Here's a perfect example, y'all. Even with little to no screen time, homie still got busy. This brother here has been down since day one and we know nothing about him. For this guy's one line on the show to be him taking all the weapons and the grenade.
That be mine. In fact, all that's mine. Got a law degree?
I mean, that's crazy, y'all. This is Weebay level loyalty right here.
Nah.
Given to a secondary character. The hustlers on The Wire were a different breed, y'all. Quick disclaimer, y'all. Cats like Vondas, Stringer Bell, and Chris Partlow won't be on this list. They weren't soldiers, y'all. We gotta respect the stripes.
Fuck your stripes, I'm McNulty.
And like always, Big Rich, like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. To my day ones, the membership link is now active. If y'all got any interest, check it out. If there's someone missing or you don't like the order, get in the comment section, let me know who and why. I look forward to chopping it up with you. Now at number five, we got two gangsters from opposite ends of the map. I couldn't choose between the two. We got Lamar, we got Odo.
Let's go all West Coast.
Now sometimes being a soldier, that shit means doing things you don't want to do. But that's where the loyalty comes in. That's where the discipline shines. Lamar had to search for Omar on a nightly basis. Homie had to search for him in a gay bar. Lamar didn't want no part of this.
You could do this better. You're the perfect bait, Lamar.
Lamar showed up again and again and again.
And I'm back tomorrow.
Now, with all seriousness, Lamar's sacrifice worked out in the long run because it drew Omar's girlfriend out of hiding. And this scene here led to one of the greatest moments in television history.
Omar, isn't it?
Then you got Old Dog, another icon whose name is historic, but for a different reason. This brother here is responsible for getting Bodie Bodas eliminated. Not only that, he caught a stray in the leg, and his reward was taking a false bid. Going away for a couple years. Again, the loyalty shines. Yeah, he bitched a little with Snoop, but at the end, he did what he was told.
I get shot up and in this shit? Y'all ask a lot, don't you?
Cat, go down Walmart or some shit and see if they take care of you while you laid up for a while.
Next to number four, we got one of my personal favorites, Cuddy. Fresh out the pen and back on the streets.
The joint might have broke him.
Now, it took Cuddy a minute to lock in, but once he did, that age and experience shined. He was militant, he was tactical, and he had a true understanding of what was going on in these streets.
You need to look beyond what he's driving and wearing on his back. That boy got a girlfriend.
He didn't react on impulse, he took time to understand the situation. I mean, still to this day, one of my favorite scenes is that stare he gave Fruit. Basically, Fruit robbed him. That stare Cuddy gave, oh man, it was ice cold. It was chilling, y'all. But real spit, it took this situation with Fruit for Cuddy to realize the game wasn't in him anymore. Because him and Slim ran down on Marlo's crew. Cuddy had him in his sights. He had motive. He had a reason to do it. But he held back. He realized his soldiering days were behind him.
Couldn't squeeze the trigger.
Him chopping it up with Avon, telling Avon the game wasn't in him anymore, it's still one of the most powerful scenes on this show.
The game ain't in me no more. None of it.
I mean, how could you not respect a soldier like this? Confront you like a man. I mean, it's such a dope scene because Avon respected it too.
He a man today.
Question I have for you guys is, do you think Avon was a little jealous? Cuddy's ability to leave the game freely. Do you think there was a little bit of envy or jealousness there? Y'all get in the comment section, let me know your thoughts.
Yeah, man.
And at number three, we got Weebay. Let me be specific here. We're not talking about the wise, humble Weebay season four. Nah.
My word is still my word.
We talking about the gangster-ass, street-savvy soldier from season one.
You got $20,000 D coming into your shop, and you ain't even around to see that shit right.
Weebay was a wild boy, y'all. He's basically Avon's version of Chris or Snoop, however you want to look at it. But Weebay needed a scorecard to keep up with his body.
You need a scorecard to keep up with your leap glass.
Shout out to Hassan Johnson. He played this scene brilliantly. He is hands down the most loyal cat on the show. He fell on his sword for the Barksdale organization without flinching. The way he owned up to all the bodies is by far one of the hardest scenes on this show.
You want to even dream about straight life for all these bodies? You got to wake up talking about Avon Barksdale and Stringer Bell.
Nah. His mannerisms, the joy and love he had for that pit sandwich, knowing it was going to be the last one he ever ate in his life.
For another pit sandwich and some tater salad, I'll go a few more.
He was more upset about the tater salad than anything else.
I had a tater salad, that's law.
Also put his life on the line for Avon. While bringing them cheese fries at that, Bay was vicious with it, y'all.
They had cheese fries, baby. I got you some.
Next at number two, the day one savage, Bodie Brodus.
You ready to put the work in?
He's definitely one of those soldiers you want in the trenches with you when shit hits the fan. Real shit, Bodie's character put in so much work. I mean, this would be a 6-hour video if I listed everything homie did on the show.
You know my name.
Actually, he's one of the few characters I wish made it out the game. When he told McNulty he felt old. That's like someone working a job for 20 years, realizing their whole life done passed them by.
This game is rigged, man. We like the little bitches on the chessboard.
Putting in all that work to establish yourself, just to have a savage like Marlo Stanfield come along and take your shit? Oh my goodness.
I need you to walk back up there and pack up your people. I'm being a gentleman about it for the moment.
I wish Bodie would have been that smart ass pawn, but nope. The game ended for Bodie just like it does for most soldiers. And at number one, a shocker to nobody, we got the ultimate soldier, Slim Charles. The OG of OGs, the solid of solids.
Y'all trifling with Avon Barksdale reputation here.
Y'all at home might think he's higher up, shouldn't be on this list. Let's stop that. The brother told us multiple times he's good where he's at.
Meaning no disrespect. But I ain't cut out to be no CEO.
This character was special. He was the only character on the show to learn from the two best hustlers on the show, Avon Barksdale and Prop Joe. I mean, Avon was with the shits.
Shut that fucking door.
Avon was more of a savage. He was war ready, always on his guard.
I'm gonna go do this shit my damn self.
And with Prop Joe, I mean, Prop was more diplomatic. Also with Prop, he always saw the bigger picture.
Cautious as those Greeks be, who you think they gonna trust? They know us. They don't know him.
Slim Charles really had the two best hustlers on the show to learn from. The brother has some of the best quotes on the show.
I mean, shit. It's what war is, you know? Once you in it, you in it.
He knew when to talk his shit, and he knew when to be quiet.
If it's a lie, then we fight on that lie.
And shit, he never showed fear. Omar had him, dead to rights. And Slim was ready to go.
Come on, yo. Finish.
I mean, thank you, David Simons, for not having Omar pull that trigger. Could y'all imagine losing Bodie Brodus and then Slim Charles? And then for Slim Charles to really show you the type of character and person he was. So close to grabbing the connect. Freedom from Marlo Stanfield. And what does he do? He puts one in cheese at the most opportunistic moment.
That was for Joe.
I'm not an advocate for shooting someone, but this is one of the best scenes in the entire series, y'all. Also one of the funniest.
This sentimental motherfucker just cost us money.
Calling his brother sentimental was funny as shit. He just executed someone in cold blood. And you're calling him sentimental? Oh man, perfect writing, y'all. Perfect writing. And then for the last scene with Slim Charles, you see him at the table getting the connect. Come on, y'all. There's no better ending for this character. Slim Charles was that smart-ass pawn. I mean, Slim to me is one of the best soldiers in television history. No disrespect to these guys.
Shorty boy, when it cleans his old act up.
Anyway, y'all, I hope y'all enjoyed this. Like always, Big Rich, thanks so much for watching. And if you're still here, Make sure you hit that subscribe button with notifications on. And I will be doing content on the HBO and HBO Max series, The Penguin. It does drop September 8th. I'll be doing reaction videos. So if y'all have any interest in that, please keep a lookout for it. And real spit, y'all don't know how much I appreciate every single one of y'all. Chop Shop family, I'll see you next time.